Now here, you see, today we'll be dealing with polygenic inheritance. So what is polygenic? Poly means many, genic means name. So two or more genes controlling a single character. For example, single character controlled by two or more genes is called polygenic inheritance. Now you see, what is that? Now polygenic influence, see, it has certain factors that can also influence that on the influence of the three genes. For example, environment and geographic condition. Now example is, see, if, for example, the skin color is done by A, B and C. These three genes are responsible for the skin color and they are supposed to be the dominant variety. That very dark skin color, okay, will have double A, double B and double C. Three genes for skin color. And a fair person, very fair, extreme fair, will have double A, double B and double C. So skin colors varies from capital A to this. So this is the condition where that can be seen by the genetic conditions. Okay. Now if you see properly, I'll show you. Okay, now another thing. Now if you see this, that is pleiotropy. Now what is pleiotropy? Pleiotropy is a single gene. Okay, you focus here carefully. For example, a single gene can exhibit multiple phenotypic expression. For example, phenylketonuria. Now phenylketonuria, if you can see, phenylketonuria is basically a genetical disorder, you may call, or it is a, in normal condition, you know, phenylketonuria, it is a genetically controlled product that through the human kidney. Okay, so that is there. So that is excreted through the human kidney. So if one gene that is controlling the phenylketonuria is somewhat mutated, the person will not be able to release that phenylketonuria and it would be become phenylalanine, like that. So this product completely controls one gene and many other disorders. So it is also taken as genetically linked genetically disorder, that phenylketonuria. It's also a disease. When we'll be dealing with it, I'll give it to you in detail. Okay, now the next point is that sex determination. Now if you see, focus here, you see that XX and XY, these are the two genes generally responsible, and it was founded by Henkin in 1891. Now if in human chromosome we have 23 pairs of chromosome, in which 22 are autosome. What is autosome? Autosomes is basically the gene that is responsible for body function, and it has it is same for every individual. Okay, now one pair, only one single pair that is responsible for the sex determination, it was taken by Henkin, that it is an X factor, double X. So in the home, if it is double X, it is considered to be a female, and if it is XY, that means homozygous condition, is double X, is a female, and in the heterozygous condition, Y, that is the male phenotype. Okay, now if you see here, you focus here, the rest of the chromosome here, it is named as this X0 type of sex chromosome, in which the male have only one X chromosome besides the autosome. See, 22 pairs of autosomes are there. Okay, and XY type, it is for the this thing, a male. Okay, so X chromosome, you see, is present in both the thing. If it, both the male and the female, X chromosomes is there, but only one Y factor is there that demarcates the male and the female chromosome. Okay, so now here we have a male heterogamy. Now the sex determination mechanism is in, for example, of male heterogamy. In other words, birds and different mechanisms sex determination observe. That means total number of autosomes and this, and even male heterogamy, and in case of female it is known as the female heterogamy. Okay, so these are the terms. That means it is a mechanism by which sex determination is there. Okay, now in human beings, I have already told you that we have 22 pairs of chromosomes. 22 pairs, this is for all the body functions. That means the liver, heart, kidney, skin, eye color, that might be. And only the X and the Y chromosome, that is basically demarcates the female or the male. And now you see, as we had done in the earlier class, that gametes segregate. So segregation, that means XY and XX, they all segregate. So 50% of the total sperm count carry X and 50% carry Y. And in female, if the zygote, it is XX. Okay, and the fertilized ovum has Y carrying the sperm, resulted into a male offspring. This we have already done. Okay, but if you take a single cell, the autosomes there. Now here we have got a main very interesting thing, that is known as mutation. Now here in simple language, you see, mutation means any change in the chemistry of DNA leads to mutation. That means what? The genetical sequence. Okay, the genetical sequence, if by any chance get changed, so you get a mutant variety. And the factors that is responsible for mutation is known as mutagen. For example, ultraviolet rays, chemicals in tobacco, radiations. Okay, and now certain geographical conditions also may lead to mutation. Okay, now here you see what is mutation, what in your book it is. So mutation in a phenomena which leads to the alteration of DNA sequence. I gave you a very simplified definition that any change in the chemistry of DNA, that means DNA sequences, and consequently result in the change of the genotype and phenotype of an organism. In addition to that, recombination, mutation in other phenomena may lead to a variation in DNA. That means it is completely entirely different from what it was. Okay. So it might be, and sometimes chromosomal aberration, that means certain part of the chromosome gets, aberration means abnormality, may lead to the cancer. For example, your skin repairing, if we take it, it has got certain number of measured quantity. Now, certain number of measured cells that has to be produced. So if that quantity of cell number varies, so the skin will grow in a multiple number, unaltered, so that means skin or a particular organ may grow, starts growing, or it may start shrinking if it starts dividing. So that is the condition that may lead to cancer. So mutation can also lead to cancer, and see, it is mutagen. Okay, ultraviolet radiation can cause mutation, that is known as mutagen. Okay.